the old office of the Agence Universitaire de la Francophonie. And this is also where the Faculté de Linguistique Appliquée, Applied Linguistic Faculty was. And this is where we are meeting the Vice Dean of the State University of Haiti.
Here is the campus for the science faculty. The whole building is like collapsing, and it should be destroyed. And this one is the third campus we are visiting. And this building could not be used again. We have to destroy it.
We are going to École Supérieure d'Infotronique Haïti, ESIH. It's an institution that proposes two four-year programs, one in computer science and one in business management. So as you can see, the site here is completely destroyed. So this is the main building, which is totally destroyed. The little building you see on the side here is mostly the library, two labs, two classrooms, and the virtual reality lab. Those haven't been destroyed, and we have been able to recuperate those. In this main building, we had about 200 students at the time of the earthquake. Most of them had time to leave, but we still lost 13 students and one professor. This is the classroom where I was supposed to teach, 45 minutes after the earthquake. So this was the building before the earthquake. So beside the ground floor, we had three floors. So everything you see here are those three floors, totally flat here. This is an institution that's about 15 years old. We are right now, what we are doing, we are working in parallel on three fronts. The first front is to have access to capital, to rebuild. This is the main need today of the universities in Haiti, is to access capital, to rebuild. The second thing is managing the transition. We are trying to make sure that our students are not losing the year. And we are planning to restart operation in a new location on March 15 with a very reduced amount of students, because a lot of them have gone to the province and a lot of them have lost their homes here in Port-au-Prince. So even if they are willing to come back here, it's not going to be easy for them to start studying again because they have no way to stay. So those are all kinds of problems that we have to deal with. Also, the buying power of the students and the parents is basically reduced to zero now. The third thing is really to the access to capital to buy a new property and build a new campus, so we can restart operation in our new definitive campus in about probably one year and a half, if everything goes well.
Nos 13 campus se situent chacun